الحمد لله الحمد لله الكريم المجيب لكل سائل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في أرضه وسمائه، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. القائل: أنا سيد ولد آدم ولا فخر. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه. الابتلاء، هذا هو عنوان لقائي مع حضراتكم، والله أسأل أن يجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. الابتلاء أيها الإخوة الأعزاء، الدنيا دار ابتلاء، حياة الدنيا حياة فيها السراء وفيها الضراء وفيها الفرحة وفيها المصيبة، وقد أخبرنا الله تعالى أننا سنبتلى. قال تعالى في سورة البقرة: ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. وقال في سورة آل عمران: لتبلون في أموالكم وأنفسكم. وقال في سورة الأعراف: وقطعناهم في الأرض أمما منهم الصالحون ومنهم دون ذلك وبلوناهم بالحسنات والسيئات. وقال في سورة الأنبياء: كل نفس ذائقة الموت ونبلوكم بالشر والخير فتنة وإلينا ترجعون. وقال في سورة الملك: تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم. نعم، ستفتن، ستبتلى. إذا قال الإنسان أنا مؤمن لا بد أن يبتلى. أقرر، إذا قلت أنا مؤمن، إذا قال الإنسان أنا مؤمن لا بد أن يبتلى. قال تعالى: أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله ألا إن نصر الله قريب. وقال في سورة الأنقبوت ألف لام ميم: أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. ستبتلى وستفتن. الله تعالى لم يجعل أسعد الناس في هذه الدنيا مثلا أكثرهم مالا وأكثرهم نعمة، وإنما جعل السعداء عنده أكثر الناس بلاء. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: من يرد الله به خيرا يصب منه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. اللهم صل على رسول الله. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. All thanks are due to Allah, the one and only creator, the supreme and the most high. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a question in the Quran, in Surah Yunus. قل من رب السماوات والأرض قل من يرزقكم من السماوات والأرض أمن يملك السمع والأبصار ومن يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي ومن يدبر الأمر. A question. Ya Muhammad, Ya Rasulullah, ask them, مَنْ يَوْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Who provides for you? Who provides for you from heaven and on the earth? أَمَّنْ يَمْلِكُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبَصَارُ. Who controls the hearing, السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارُ and the sight. وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ. And who brings out الْحَيِّ, the living, مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ, from the death, from the dead. وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ. And who brings out the dead from the living? Who? Allah said, فَسَيَقُولُونَ اللَّهُ. The answer they will give you, these qualities that you just mentioned, Ya Muhammad, the only one who has the power, who is doing it, is Allah. فَقُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Now say, why won't you then fear him? Will you not then fear him? The one who has the power of all this. فَذَٰلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمُ الْحَقُّ. Such is your Lord, your true Lord, your true sustainer, the cherisher. فَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ. What is after? After the truth. What is going to be after the truth? If not error, if not lie. So whatever you take, if you take something else beside Allah, to let you know, Allah is the only true God, and He is the only sustainer, the cherisher. He is the only true God and the provider. If you take something else beside Allah, listen to this parable in the Quran. مثل الذين اتخذوا من دون الله أولياء. The parable, the example, the likeness of those who took من دون الله. They took helpers, protectors, other than Allah. كمثل العنكبوت اتخذت بيتا. It's like the home of a spider. It's like a spider who took home for itself. Have you ever seen the house of a spider? So if you take something else other than Allah as your protector and your God, Allah said you are like a spider who took a home for itself. كمثل العنكبوت اتخذت بيتا. And tell me about it. وإن أوهن البيوت لبيت العنكبوت. Is there any home weaker than the weak of than the home of a spider? Easily destroyed, easily terminated, easily destroyed. So brothers and sisters in Islam, whatever you take as a provider, as your helper, as your protector, if it's not Allah, it is zero. So go back to who? ربكم الحق, your true Lord, the cherisher, the sustainer, Allah. He is one and only one. I bear witness. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Nabiullah Ibrahim prayed for his coming, Muhammad. رَبَّنَا وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم.
He prayed, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, provide for them someone special from you. And that special someone is Muhammad. Nabiullah Isa alayhi salam gave the good news of the coming of Muhammad.
وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ.
So he said, أَنَا دَعْوَةُ أَبِي إِبْرَاهِيمٍ
وَبُشْرَى عِيسَى.
I am the dua, the supplication of my father Ibrahim, and I am the good news that Moses is again. I am the good news that Jesus, peace be upon him, gave before he departs. Before he departs. So for those who are saying he is not a messenger, look at Allah. Can I ask a question? Is there any witness better than Allah? Allah said, I am a witness.
هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا محمد رسول الله.
Allah said, believe me, Ya Muhammad, I am the witness. You are my messenger. You are my messenger. Allah said, I swear by the Quran.
Yasin. والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين.
يا محمد, I swear by my book, the Quran, that you are my messenger. You are one of my messengers. You are among my messengers.
And he is the key and the final and the seal of prophethood, Muhammad. He is the only way at the moment. No one goes to Allah except through Muhammad.
I pray that, Ya Allah, we love you and we love your messenger. We pray that we see our beloved Prophet Muhammad in Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, trials, challenges, temptations, hardship. This is my message. This is my reminder. This life that we are living today, brothers, in it there is happiness. In it there is sorrow. There is sadness. So now, brothers and sisters in Islam, I have questions to ask. Are you sad because you are seriously sick? Are you sad because you lost someone you love so much? Maybe my sister or my brother, are you sad because you are divorced? Or maybe are you sad because your son is seriously ill? Or maybe are you sad or because you don't have enough money to take care of your family? Are you sad because you don't have a stable job? Are you sad because your business is not moving the way it's supposed to be? Brothers and sisters in Islam, this life that we are living is a bird of trials. It's a bird of trials. It's a home of trial, temptation, challenges, hardship. And this is the promise that Allah said in the Quran. He said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. Allah said, I will test you. I will test you with something of fear, with something مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ of fear, والجوع and hunger, والنقص من الأموال and loss of wealth, والأنفس and life, والثمرات and fruit. But one thing, وبشر الصابرين, give good tidings to the patient. الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Yes, we are from Allah and we are going back from to Allah. Whatever happened to us, we know is good because we believe in Allah. This is the promise that we will be tested. If you go to Surah Ali Imran, he said,
لتبلون في أموالكم وأنفسكم.
You will be tested in your wealth and in your life. You will be tested in your life, in your wealth, maybe in your business. Maybe you don't have enough, you don't have a good job. Maybe you cannot take care of your family. In your life, maybe you are sick. You are sick. They just told you that you have a sickness that it cannot be cured. My brother, let me tell you, there is nothing powerful. There is no one who cures but Allah. Just have the hope and give it to Him. Whatever they say, believe me, Allah is the strongest. And He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can heal you no matter what. So, لَتُبْلَوَنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ. If you go to Surah Al-A'raf, he said, وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ. And we try them, we test them, بِالْحَسَنَاتِ بِالسَّيِّئَاتِ وَالْحَسَنَاتِ, with evil and good. Brother, do you know if they test you with calamities, it's a test? Do you know if he tests you with wealth, he make you wealthy, do you know it's a test too? Yes, it is. Both is a test. If you go to Surah Al-Anbiya,
كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَنَبَلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ.
If you go to Surah Al-Mulk,
الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا.
He created al-maut, death and life. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ, who will do the most good deeds. So we will be tested. And brothers and sisters in Islam, as long as you say I am a Muslim, as long as you say I am a believer, a mu'min, you said, I believe in Allah. Allah said, I will test you. I will test you. Listen to this ayah, please, in Surah Al-Ankabut. Please listen to it carefully.
Alif Lam Mim. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ.
So do men, do people think they will just get away by saying we believe and we are not going to try them? And we are not going to test them? Listen to the next ayah.
وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ.
Yes, we tried, we tested those who came before them, and with this Allah will know among you who is telling the truth and who is a liar. Now, you can ask me a question. So are you telling me that the only way Allah will know that I am a good person or I am a truthful believer is after he tests me? No. This is not the understanding. First, you should know, he knows what had happened. He knows what is happening. He knows what will happen. I repeat, he knows the past. He knows what's happening. And he knows what will happen in future. He knows everything. But here, by saying that Allah will know, it's you yourself. Our scholars said, Allah said that to tell you, he wants you yourself, the claimer of faith. You claim that I am a believer, so now he will test you. Because at the time of happiness, you said I'm a believer, so now he will test you. Now give the answer to your own self. Whenever now that calamity happened, something very serious happened, will you be on the same stage or you will change? So you have to answer. You are the one who is going to know indeed if you are a true believer or not. Now you understand the ayah? So Allah, you yourself, you will know if I am a true believer or not. To be your own judge. Why?
اقرأ كتابك.
Why?
ووجدوا ما عملوا حاضرا ولا يظلم ربك أحدا.
Allah wants you yourself to be your own witness. That's why he is trying you, so that when you stand in front of him, he asks you, you know, and you know. So brothers, if you are in this life, you will be tested. You will be tried. You will go through challenges. It's happened. We all have our share in these challenges. If you hear what someone is going through, yours will be just like a child's play. Yours will be like a toy. If you hear what someone is going through, he sees you, you meet him, he laughs, he smiles, he hugs you. But what he is going through in his life, if he tells you, wallahi, for you, yours, you will just sleep and snore. You will be snoring. Because if you hear what some other people are going through, and do you know that if he loves you, he tests you more. Do you know that? I repeat, if he loves you, he wants good for you, he tests you more. Example. Listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُصِبْ مِنْهُ. If Allah wants to do good for a person, يُصِبْ مِنْهُ, he will afflict him with trials, problem after problem, trials after trials, challenges, hardship, because he loves you. That's why. Let me give you an example. If you see a necklace on the neck of a woman, it passes through many processes, heating process, before you see it on her neck shining. This is it. If you see a necklace shining, golden necklace, it went through many heating process, and at the end you will see it blinking. Okay, you will see it blinking on the neck of a woman. Yes, brothers, he tested those he loved the most. If I ask you, who are the ones who Allah loves the most, you will tell me his messengers and prophets. Let's take the journey in the Quran. First, brothers, he tested Nuh. 950 years he went through many trials. Brothers, at the end, he had to call Allah for help. He asked Allah for help. وَلَقَدْ نَادَانَا نُوحٌ فَلَنِعْمَ الْمُجِيبُونَ فَدَعَا رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. He tried Nuh. He tested Nuh. Brothers, he tried Ibrahim. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. He tried Ibrahim, many trials. He tried Zakaria, brothers and sisters in Islam. رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا وَلَمْ أَكُن بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا. وَزَكَرِيَّا إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. He tried
Ayyub.
وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ.
He tried him. Brothers, he tried all of them. He tried our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But quickly, 1 or 2 minutes, I want us to take a little journey in Surah to Yusuf with me. Come. Let's see the trials of the one he loves. The love of Allah. Allah loves all his creation. But when it comes to the messengers and the prophets, they are special. But come to Yusuf alayhi salam. Brothers, tests after tests. First test.
اقتلوا يوسف او اطرحوه ارضا يخلو لكم وجه ابيكم.
Kill Yusuf. Kill him. Or you know what? Just go and throw him somewhere far. No. You know what?
لا تقتلوا يوسف وألقوه في غيابة الجب.
Oh, now you know what? Let's just go and throw him in an unused well, which they did. First trial, with your father, with your family, happily they took him, they threw him in the well. What happened? He was saved by Allah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent some caravan. They came and they saved him. They removed him from it. So he was saved. Trial number two. Now they sold him as a slave.
وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودًا وَكَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الزَّاهِدِينَ.
Now they sold Yusuf. Nabiullah Yusuf sold. A trial.
He was saved again. Listen to Allah.
وقال الذي اشتراه من مصر لامرأته أكرمي مثواه.
The one, his master, the one who bought him, he told his wife, I want you to treat him honorably. So after this trial again, he was saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Trial number three.
وراودته التي هو في بيتها عن نفسه وغلقت الأبواب وقالت هيت لك قال معاذ الله.
His master's wife tries to seduce him. Another trial. He was saved.
وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا.
When she desired him, he would have desired her, if not because of the indication of his Lord, Allah.
وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَنْ رَأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ.
Another trial. Now he has to go to prison. He was in prison for a crime he did not commit. Brothers, are you following this? Trial, saved. Trial, saved. This is life. This is life. He is in prison. Now he is saved again. He came out.
وقال الملك توني بي.
Now he came out as a king. He came out as a king. This is life. You will go through trials. But at the end, at the end of the surah, Allah is reminding you and I.
لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ.
Yes, in their account, there is a lesson that you should always remember. Okay. Those who have the wisdom and they reason, they know. Yes, in the accounts of this, of the life of the messengers and the prophets, there is one, there is a lesson for us to learn. We will be tested. You will be tested. But brothers,
مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى.
Allah said, it is not a fictitious tale. It is not a lie. What happened to Noah? What happened to Ibrahim, Ayub, Zakaria, Musa, Isa, Yusuf? All of them, our Prophet Muhammad, it is not a fictitious tale.
وَلَكِمْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ.
So we will be tested. But at the end, let me give you good news. As long as you are a Muslim, we said you will be tried, you will be tested. But at the same time, as long as you are a believer, Allah said to tell you,
وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
It is the duty on us to help the believer. You will be helped. May Allah help you. Whatever you are going through, do not worry. You are going through tests so that Allah will elevate your rank hereafter. Because this life here will finish and the hereafter is everlasting. Brothers and sisters in Islam, our Imam, Imam Muhammad Silla, this week we lost one of a brother, his brother, who was very sick, who went for treatment in Ghana, and Allah took him over there. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. No one knows where he will die. From Gambia? Okay, your land, your grave is in Ghana. So he went to remind our Imam what he knows. I repeat, to remind our Imam what he knows.
وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ.
We pray, may Allah forgive him. May Allah give him Jannah. We all lost loved ones. Ya Allah, forgive them. Ya Allah, give them Jannah. When it's time for us to go, Ya Allah, we pray that our final word, La ilaha illallah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, please, you donate generously, always. But this donation of today, please, I want you to make it special because you're trying to help a sick person. We have someone who we want in the masjid, ask them for help to help a sick person. Please, whatever you will give or you used to give, double it.
Allah will help you. May Allah make things easy for you. So please, after the prayer, give generously, and it will be given, inshallah, to the sick person to help him, inshallah, in his medications. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make things easy for us. And tonight, inshallah, we have a message. If you have the time, please come. The message is, if you can come with your child, please come with him, especially those of them who are going to colleges. Today, between Maghrib and Isha, we are going to answer some questions and to defend or to give the proofs. Because brothers and sisters in Islam, do you know, they said alcohol in Islam is not haram. But Allah just said, only make sure you don't drink when you are praying. But after that, you can drink. Do you know they said that? Do you know they said that Allah did not say for us to gather here and pray Jumu'ah in the Quran? Yes, they did. Please tonight come and let's discuss what they said and what Allah and His Messenger said, and let's see who is speaking the truth tonight between Maghrib and Isha. Allahumma hadina fi man hadait, wa afina fi man afait, wa tawallana fi man tawallait, wa barik lana fi ma atait. Allahumma hadina wa hadina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-ali al-azim. Allahumma اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. وقوموا الى صلاتكم يرحمكم.